And I'm here with
Seth Panman
and John Wesley Shipp.
Okay, so guys, how was it working together?
I think it was great.
I don't know.
I hope I don't hear anything different right now. He's going to say, oh, it was awful. I hated John.
Well, I mean, no, it was awesome. It was amazing.
Producers, and Seth helped me actually with my characterization. When I told you earlier, I said he had this boss that would be normal 1 minute, and then he'd be right up in your face, you know, the next, and spittle flying, and then the next minute he'd go right back to zero. And so he sort of set the template at a crucial moment in the film.
Yeah, it was zero to 60 mentality is what we call this. It was, you know, when John was having trouble with that, I just said zero to 60, and he'd be like,
Right.
So what was the craziest moment on set?
The craziest moment on set.
We might have had different crazy moments. I think it was when we had to move a whole hospital room from New Jersey to a alleyway in Bushwick, Brooklyn.
Ah!
I think that was the craziest moment.
I can't top that.
Yeah, that was pretty bad. I don't know if John even knew about that, but I was beat up for weeks. Like mild PTSD from that one. No night sweats, but like PTSD. Yeah.
That's the next film.
Yeah, that's the follow-up.
Night Sweats Part 2, PTSD.
Yeah,
yes.
PTSD. That's our spin-off.
I'm looking forward to that. And did you guys eat? How are you guys doing today? Like, how do you feel today?
How do you feel that it's being finally presented?
Honestly, I couldn't be happier. I mean, I'm thrilled. We're at Robert De Niro's home, so that's an honor to be here. We sold out every night at Essex Regal, where we premiere tomorrow. And I'm here with John Wesley Shipp. So, I mean, like, what could be better?
You know, an interesting thing is that the two parts of the story come from you, don't they?
Yeah.
That you moved to New York and you went to work for this self-help place, and then you showed up one day and it was shuttered and barred, and they stiffed you on your salary.
Yeah, I went to get my last check, and there was literally phone jacks hanging out of the wall, and they were gone, the company. But more than that was actually the verbal and physical abuse that went on at the company. Not so much with me because I fought back, but there was, you know, with other people. But I took some hitters. I was new to New York, so I thought like getting punched at the job was like a New York thing. But then I was like, oh wait, this isn't a New York thing.
Right. And also, you bet the people there that wanted you to film docu-style.
Yeah, well, the whole
thing, spreading of the illness?
Not at the company. That came after.
Oh, that came after.
I kind of compare that to, like, if you're the CEO of Dunkin' Donuts, but right before they went bankrupt and you saved the company, that was the reputation I had. They were like, come over here and film this story of trauma.
Oh, my
so God. It wasn't the company. They actually had good intentions aside from, like, you know, bruising people at work once in a while. They were cool.
They were creating trauma that they were filming.
Exactly. They were like, you know, you guys aren't working. We'll get it done in-house. I call it the startup culture. So it was like at the beginning of that inception when companies, you know, they're well-funded. They have a madman at the helm. And, like, so that was that. But afterwards is really what the story was born from, the aftermath.
So listen, I know you have a lot in the works. What's next?
So, yeah, it's been a really exciting year with the success of Night Sweats, and we've got a lot of great projects going on. I just started my 7th production company, which is called a ThreeWay product. And I'm working with co-founder and co-producer Amanda B. Goodman, who's from Broad City and Yodo. So yeah, we've got a lot of cool stuff going on. But our golden goose, our golden egg, is an episodic live action piece that is Sex and the City meets The X-Files. It's the most dynamic duo, which is a female-male duo. And it's the biggest, most intense underdog story, New York story you've ever seen. And it's about a wannabe Wall Street lender and a wannabe sex educator, and basically their grind and hustle in New York City. And the thing that gets me really excited, and I always like to talk about excitement because content's exciting, but I'm a business guy and I'm a sales guy, and the thing that's really exciting is for investors. We have a product line that is 5 products deep. It's a pipeline of products. And all products have been reverse engineered into the marketplace based on the prior to the content arriving, and 2 of those products are already in the marketplace. The one is T-Bitch International, which is my clothing and apparel line. The other one is Healing Hyperbarics, which is my medical equipment line. The missing items that we haven't brought in, because we're still trying to field investors for them, are sex toys, CBD products, and a hemp line. So, you know, we're talking about industries that are all red hot in their own right, and so 2020 is going to be a big year.
I'm looking forward to all of your next projects. Thank you so much, Seth.